So if you are central government employee, confusion with respect to the right pension scheme is pretty obvious. So let's decode the right kind of pension scheme for you, whether you should be going for UPS, NPS, or what are the benefits in OPS. Let's talk about what you get where. We'll start with unified pension scheme. So definitely a short pension, that's the biggest advantage. 50% of the average basic pay drawn over the last 12 months prior to superannuation will be given to you. And it's applicable, the minimum a qualifying service has to be 25 years, then only it will be applicable. Also, service period between 10 to 25 years, it's proportional for service periods between 10 to 25 years, again a very important criteria. And what about after the demise of the pension gainer? 60% of the employee's pension immediately will be given after their demise to their family. And what about the minimum pension? So a minimum pension of rupees 10,000 per month will be given as minimum pension of 10 years of service. Also, inflation index is applied to a short pension, a short family pension, and a short minimum pension. And dearness relief is also based on All India Consumer Price Index for industrial workers, similar to service employees. Now, there's a lump sum payment also at superannuation. 1/10 of monthly emoluments, that is pay plus DA for every completed 6 months of service. Let's talk about NPS now, which is the National Pension Scheme. And one should know that most states and union territory governments have also notified NPS of their new employees. Now, if the state government joins UPS, they would bear the additional burden for those employees for the assured pension. Let's talk about the features. So NPS actually gives you pension based on the contributions made by the employees and the government. You have to, when you take up an NPS scheme, you have to invest that money based on the schemes available under NPS, which also includes equity and fixed income oriented schemes. And apart from that, at the age when you want to take off the money, 60% will be EEE, that is exempt, and the rest 40% you will have to buy an annuity plan based on which you will get a pension, which will be decided by you, and that will be based on the corpus that's accumulated by you. And a 10% contribution from the central government, employee's basic salary, and 14% contribution from the government is what is required. But also talking about UPS, now employees' contribution would remain 10% while the government contribution would increase to 18.5%. Now that's the basic difference between the contribution when we talk about NPS versus UPS. And also the pension amount is not fixed. As I already explained, NPS, it is a market-linked scheme and it is subject to market movements, especially in the equity exposure that you might have taken as per the scheme. Whereas in UPS, it provides you a short pension, which is 50% of the salary for those who joined the service after Jan 1st, 2004. Now, NPS also has tax benefits, ATC and ATCCD2, and the family pension under NPS is dependent on the corpus that you've been accumulated, that you have accumulated in the pension fund actually, and post that the annuity plan that you choose after retirement, and you want the payout depending on your comfort level, whether you want it monthly, quarterly, or 6 monthly. Now, NPS has been implemented for all government employees except those in the armed forces joining the central government on or after Jan 1st, 2004. It is also available for private sector employees. Let's talk about old pension scheme. Now, in old pension scheme, retired government employees receive 50% of their last drawn salary as monthly pension. The amount keeps increasing with the hike in the DA rates. Employees were entitled to a gratuity payment of a minimum of rupees 20 lakh on retirement. Now, in cases if a retired employee passes away, their family receives continued pension benefits, and no deductions are made from any employee salary towards pension contribution under OPS, unlike NPS. States like Himachal Pradesh, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh, Punjab have reverted to the old pension scheme.